मेरो नाती र खेतला छोरी अर्को आदमी दुईजना अर्को एउटा छजना मरो
We are now in Chukum and I am surrounded by mountains as you can see here. After a while, we will be taking up the hard trail to Imja. I managed to reach up to here. I think I still have some energy left to walk up towards the lake. After 8 days of trekking every day, we had lost all our strength and now we are walking very slowly. It is actually a 2-hour walk from here to Imja Lake, but it could take us more than 4 hours. There was no place to halt there, so we had to reach fast and rush back to Chukum as soon as possible before it got dark. As we walked over the vast stretch of grassland, we realized that this is the same route where the flood could come down rushing from Imja Lake and attack Chukum, first destroying the small settlement down there. Now we are getting close. We can already see the lake from here. The lake seems massive, much larger than we had imagined. It is hard to believe that all this used to be glaciers. By 1960, most of the glacier melted and turned into a lake. The lake is growing as more glaciers are retreating fast and melting at the rate of nearly 10 meters every year. We were successful to witness the direct impact of global warming on the glaciers. Now we have to see what happens when the glacial lake bursts out of the moraine walls. We decided to go to Diksho Lake from where the flood was unleashed. At Thamu, we met Ang Maya Sherpa, who had witnessed the destructive flood when she was just a teenager. She offered to show us all the hills and villages destroyed by the flood. The flood had killed about 5 people and had destroyed several bridges. The roads were cut off for 2 months. All the farms were washed away. The Namji Hydro project, which was worth about 1.5 million, was completely destroyed.
एते दिन त हामी त हाम्रो एउटा चाड मनाउँदै थियो। त्यो चाड मनाइराको थियो फाङ्नी भन्ने चाड थियो हाम्रो। अनि डङडङ र डुङडुङ हाम्रो गाउँको अलि तल पर्थ्यो खोला चाहिँ ठमोको। अनि डङडर डुङडुङ भनेर आवाज आएको थियो अनि सबैले लहै बाढी आयो भनेर कराउन थाल्यो अनि त्यो ढिलको छेउमा हेर्नु जाँदा कालो बाढी गइरहेको थियो जता जता त्यो बाढीको टाउको जता जता ठोक्छ त्यतै भक कप निकालेर लान्थ्यो अनि राति समयसम्म हामी त्यही डाँडामा हेरि बसेथ्यौँ अनि राति पनि हामी डर लागेर बा हाम्रो गाउँ नै लाने हो कि भनेर हामी रातभरि रुँगेर बस्यौँ
This is just the tip of the problem caused by global warming. It is quite sad to think that all these beautiful glaciers, formed by more than 2 million years of snowfall, are receding faster in the Himalayas than anywhere in the world. Going to the glacier area was certainly the best educational journey for me to understand how global warming has directly affected our country. But I was certainly very depressed to see the reality there. Although Nepal has a minuscule share in the global warming, our country has to bear the impact of the problem made worse by the developed nations of the West.